जय श्री माता जी। सहज योगी कलाकार और संगीतकारों के साथ संवादात्मक सत्र इस कार्यक्रम में आप सभी का स्वागत है। वी वेलकम यू ऑल इन टुडेज प्रोग्राम ऑफ इंटरैक्टिव सेशन विद सहज आर्टिस्ट्स एंड म्यूजिशियंस। अब हम परम पूज्य श्री माता जी को नमस्कार करेंगे, फिर कुंडलिनी उठाकर बंधन लेंगे, उसके बाद तीन महामंत्र, श्री गणेश मंत्र और श्री माता जी के अमृतवाणी को सुनते हुए ध्यान में स्थित हो जाएंगे। नाउ वी ऑल बाउ टू श्री माता जी, देन रेज अवर कुंडलिनी एंड टेक बंधन। आफ्टर दैट थ्री महामंत्र, श्री गणेश मंत्र एंड वी विल सेटल इन मेडिटेशन व्हाइल लिसनिंग टू श्री माता जी स्पीच।
Yeah. आपल्या महाराष्ट्रात असे युवक कलाकार आहेत हे पाहून असं वाटतं की ही परंपरेने आलेली एवढी मोठी विद्या महाराष्ट्रात तरी जपून ठेवली जाईल. सर्व सहयोगांनी मी आधी सांगितलं आहे की शास्त्रीय संगीत समजलंच पाहिजे, कारण हे ओंकार आहे. आणि जेव्हा तुम्ही शास्त्रीय संगीत त्याची रागदारी ऐकता तेव्हा आपोआपच चैतन्य व्हावं लागतं आणि ते तुमच्या कुंडलिनीत इतकं परिणामकारी असतं. आधी सहजच ते सगळं घटित होतं. इतकंच नव्हे पण परदेशात जिथे जिथे सहयोग आज 16 देशात आहे सगळीकडे मी त्यांना आपण सगळ्यांनी शास्त्रीय संगीत शिकलं पाहिजे म्हणून सांगत असते आणि सर्व लोकांनी ते संगीत शिकण्याचा पूर्ण प्रयत्न केलेला आहे. इतकंच नव्हे तर न समजताही आत्म्याचं संगीत असल्यामुळे ते सगळे अगदी तल्लीन होऊन जातात. तसंच आज भारतवर्षात जेवढे सहयोगी आहेत त्यांनी आपलं शास्त्रीय संगीत पूर्णपणे उचलून धरलं पाहिजे, कारण ती माझ्या हृदयाची गोष्ट आहे. हे आत्म्याचं स्वरूप आहे, ते प्रगट रूपाने वाहत आहे. सगळ्या कलाकारांचा मान केला पाहिजे आणि ह्या कलेचा मान केला पाहिजे. सर्व कलेमध्ये संगीत हे उच्च दर्जाचं आहे, तेव्हा कोणत्या प्रकारची टीका वगैरे न करताना त्याबद्दल आदर ठेवून ते समजून घेतलं पाहिजे. म्हणजे सहयोग अत्यंत सहज होईल मला सुद्धा. असं आज आपण आम्हाला सगळ्यांना तल्लीन करून दिलं त्याबद्दल आम्ही आपले फार आभार. काल मी नागपूरच्या सर्व मंडळींना आपल्या तर्फे आभार मानले होते आणि आज परत त्यांनी येऊन इथे जे काही आपल्या कलेचं प्रदर्शन केलं त्याबद्दल सुद्धा मी त्यांचे अत्यंत आभारी आहे. त्याशिवाय उद्या आपल्या साऊथ इंडियातून आलेले चिट्टी बाबू त्यांचा विशेष अट्टहास हा की माँ आपके सामने मुझे जरूर बजाने का है, ते आलेले आहेत आणि त्यांचंही संगीत आपण समजून घेतलं पाहिजे. तेही फार उच्च प्रतीचं आहे. अशा रीतीने वैरभाव सोडून जसं आपण सांगितलं सर्व संगीतातलं जे मर्म आहे ते जर जाणून घेतलं तर त्यातला आत्मा आपल्याला नेहमीच आनंदित करतो. उद्या सर्व सहयोगांनी अवश्य आलंच पाहिजे, कारण साऊथ इंडियन म्युझिक आहे म्हणून आम्ही येणार नाही असं कुणी म्हटलेलं मला चालणार नाही. ते तुम्ही एकदा ऐका म्हणजे आपल्याला आश्चर्य वाटेल की त्यांच्यामध्ये सुद्धा किती कला आहे आणि किती मनोरंजक आहे ते. त्याशिवाय आपले टाकडे गुरुजी सुद्धा व्हायोलिनवर उद्या जवळजवळ 1 तास वाजवतील आणि आपल्याला परत मंत्रमुग्ध करतील. मी आपल्याला सुद्धा उद्या सगळ्यांना आमंत्रण देते की कृपा करून सर्वांनी यावं आणि ते संगीत ऐकून घ्यावं आणि समजून घ्यावं. त्यांनी आपल्या संगीताची शाकाहारी होऊ शकते आणि त्यांच्याही संगीताची होऊ शकते. त्यांचे जे ज्याला आपण जसं म्हणतो ताना आहेत किंवा त्यांचे जे आलाप आहेत त्यांचा जो ढंग आहे, जसं तुम्ही पंजाबी ढंग घेतला, बनारसी ढंग घेतला महाराष्ट्रात, तसाच थोडासा मद्रासी ढंग घेतला तर काही हरकत नाही आणि तो अत्यंत सुंदर असतो. अशा रीतीने आपल्याला एक समग्रता म्हणवता येईल.
कार्यक्रम में 4 महत्वपूर्ण विषय है. श्री माताजी द्वारा बताया हुआ आध्यात्मिक उत्थान में सहज संगीत का महत्व, सहज योगी कलाकार और संगीतकारों से जुड़ित सम्मान और प्रोटोकॉल। कला और संगीत में सहज योग कैसे सहायता करता है, और अंत में संवादात्मक सत्र एवं बातचीत। देर आर फोर इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स इन दिस प्रोग्राम। इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सहज म्यूजिक इन स्पिरिचुअल असेंट एज टोल्ड बाय श्री माताजी। रिस्पेक्ट एंड प्रोटोकॉल्स इन रिलेशन विथ सहज आर्टिस्ट एंड म्यूजिशियंस। हाउ सहज योगा हेल्प्स इन आर्ट एंड म्यूजिक। एंड लास्ट पार्ट विल बी इंटरैक्टिव सेशन।
Especially for music, I must say that music carries the vibrations. It's in the rhythm of it. It carries the vibrations, the lahari, which we call as Saundarya Lahari, or you can call it Chaitanya Lahari, are really carried by notes and music. And that is why all of them, though they are people not acquainted with our Indian music, they appreciate it. It has something to do with your spirit, and is known that our music has come from the Atma, and that's why everyone, they don't know any ragas, they don't know any talas, but they appreciate. And now they have started understanding even ragas and talas. आता ही गाणी झाली सुरुवातीला, ते इंग्लिशमध्ये किंवा आपण असं म्हणू की पाश्चिमात्य पद्धतीत झाली आणि तुम्हा सर्वांना ती एवढी आवडली, हे एक मोठं मला समाधान वाटलं की नाहीतर इथे सगळे संगीतज्ञ बसलेले आहेत आणि ते म्हणतील माताजी काय तुम्ही सुरू केलं. पण आपण सर्व प्रकारचं संगीत समजून घेतलं पाहिजे, अर्थात जे नुसतं काहीतरी आजकाल निघालेलं तेच म्हणत नाही मी, पण सर्व तऱ्हेचं. मला तर वेस्टर्न क्लासिकल म्युझिकचा फार नाद आहे, तसं साऊथ इंडियन म्युझिकचा मला फार नाद आहे, आणि आपला तर आहेच. तेव्हा आपली दृष्टी व्यापक करायला पाहिजे, आणि ते बघून मला फार आनंद वाटला की तुम्ही सर्वांनी जे फ्रेंच लोकांनी तुमच्यासमोर प्रस्तुत केलं. उसके बाद मुझे खासकर आज के जो अपने बड़े भारी संगीतकार मशहूर हैं उनके बारे में क्या बताऊं, आप तो जानते ही हैं कि कितनी सुंदरता से और कितने प्यार से इन्होंने अनेक तरह के गीत इकट्ठे किए. उन सब गीतों में वो आपके हृदय की बात कहे, और इसलिए आप लोगों को बहुत अच्छा लग रहा था. महाराष्ट्रीय लोकान से एक वैशिष्ट है, एकदा जर का क्लासिकल म्युझिक सुरू झालं कुठे, मग तुम्ही खेडे गावात असेल मग कुठे असला झालं, मग त्याच्यानंतर मग काय बोलायला असतो, सगळे विरघळले तेव्हा त्यांच्याबद्दल काही सांगण्यासारखं नाहीच आहे, कारण एकदम संपलंच ते. तर अजित करकरे साहेबांनी अनेकदा येऊन आम्हाला इतकं आमचं मनोरंजन केलेलं आहे की मी त्यांची ऋणी आहे आणि सर्व सहयोगी त्यांचे ऋणी. ते कबेल्याला सुद्धा आले होते, यावेळेला काही आम्ही गडबडीत सापडलो त्यामुळे काही त्यांचं बोलवणं झालं नाही, पण प्रत्येक वर्षी त्यांना बोलवलंच पाहिजे असा प्रत्येकाचा अट्टा असतो. आता इतकं सुंदर त्यांचं गाण्याची पद्धत आहे की गातात क्लासिकलच गायला पाहिजे, पण त्याच्यामध्ये जे रिदमिक पॅटर्न्स बनवतात मध्ये मध्ये आणि कधी फास्ट कधी स्लो, त्यांनी ज्याला समजत नसेल तो सुद्धा खेळून आहे, त्याला असं वाटेल की हे काहीतरी अभिनव आहे. पण आता तुम्ही जर अगदी सारखं कृष्णराव पंडित सारखं गाणं सुरू केलं तर
असं झालं 15 मिनिटात सगळं उठून जाते. तर ह्या आजकालच्या धकाधकीच्या जीवनात अशा रीतीने जे आपण आलटून पालटून गायलंय ते फारच सगळ्यांनाच, मग ते कुठल्याही देशातले असेलात का, फारच आवडलेलं आहे. सगळे अगदी स्तब्ध बसले, सगळ्यांनी फार त्याचा आनंद घेतला. त्याबद्दल मी खरोखर आपली ऋणी आहे. कारण आम्ही इथे जंगलात येऊन बसलो होता, जंगलातही म्हटलं की अजित कडकरांचं गाणं ऐकायचं म्हणजे इट्स टू मच. मी म्हटलं सुद्धा तुम्ही कशाला त्यांना त्रास दिला इतक्या इथे आणायचं खडगे मध्ये रस्त्यामध्ये सगळे आम्ही आदळत आपटत आलो. त्याच्यावर मला मग इथे आल्यावर कळलं आपण आलात तर म्हटलं झालंच, आणखी त्यांना कशाला त्रास दिला. पण आपण ज्या आस्थेने आणि ज्या प्रेमाने आपण सगळी गाणी सिलेक्ट केली आणि ते सुंदर म्हटली फारच. सगळे मला सांगतात की आम्ही अजित कडकड्यांना माताजी तुमच्या समोर ऐकतो तर त्याचं वेगळंच रूप असतं. आणि मग तसं ऐकलं तर एवढं नाही होत म्हटलं. तर हे सांगायचं म्हणजे असं की आपण एक फार धार्मिक व्यक्ती आहात इतकं सगळे, पण आपलं रिअलायझेशन झालेलं आहे आणि भक्तीचा सुद्धा खूप संचार आहे. तेव्हा या समन्वयामुळे जी एक उत्कृष्ट कलासिद्धी आपल्याला साधलेली आहे, त्याच्यामुळे हे आमचे सगळे सहयोगी, मग ते परदेशातले असो नाटका किंवा हिंदुस्थानातले असो नाटका, नेहमी म्हणतात की कमीत कमी एक प्रोग्राम तरी त्यांचा तुम्ही फॉरेनला ठेवा. ही अगदी आग्रहाची विनंती असते सगळ्या. पण मागच्या वेळा आम्ही जरा गडबडीत सापडलो, त्यामुळे ते झालं नाही. प्रत्येक वेळेला आपण जी वेळ आपल्याला साध्य होईल, जी पूजा आपल्याला साध्य होईल, ती जर आपण कळवलं तर आम्हाला बरं पडेल. म्हणजे आम्ही त्याहेनी आपल्याला बोलू, कारण आपणही फार बिझी असतात. तर आज सर्वांच्या तर्फे मी आपलं अभिनंदन करते. As if through these musicians also, our family of Sahaj Yoga is expanding so much. And the way they are realizing the oneness of our lives and oneness of our value system. As if they are all getting absolutely lost into our own families of Sahaj Yogis. It's, I don't find any difference because they all have vibrations, they all play with vibrations, and nothing goes wrong. I've seen it just like, as we say, sanchar hona. I felt there was sanchar in them the way they started playing, the whole shakti started moving in them. And it was a remarkable thing I've seen, whether they are Muslims, Christians, Hindus, Sikhs, or anything. It is, this music transcends them. This Nusrat Ali Khan Sahab was sitting on the stage. And he just looked at me. I don't know what he knows about me. He said to me, Ma, come and sit next to me. I was amazed how he recognized me. I was like any other audience sitting there. So I was sitting on the ground. He just called me. I was so surprised at this gentleman, Nusrat Ali Khan. So it transcends, you know. This music, it's divine, it transcends all races, all religion, all nonsensical, divisive ideas. No doubt about it. And that is what is Sahaj Yoga. How our music is spreading into their hearts, and this our music, which is Indian music, is really is a divine music. Also, they have very beautiful classical music, no doubt about them, and I also enjoy that very much. But our music is a different type because in this the rapport is established between the artist and the listeners. And every time they can start creating, they have freedom to create. And that's what I think the Sahaj Yogis are just all the time like to hear only our Indian classical music, all the time. And they appreciate it very much. Whatever country they may come from, but you'll be amazed how they enjoy this music. And this is to also say one of the desires of my father, that he said that our music is so divine, it should reach the whole world. I don't know if it is Sahajog that has helped you, but this collective singing is the biggest thing. Collective in tune with all other musicians is really very, very great, and this union, this oneness, if it is through Sahajog, I'm very happy about it. We are all overly satisfied, and I can see your future. It will be a great future for all of you. We shouldn't take so much of botheration about how we'll do it and how will it work out. It will work out. Your desire is much stronger than the desire of any other artist. So just desire, it will all work out, and we'll show to them how Sahaja Yoga can create such beautiful music. I would request all the Indians to develop that subtle understanding. You see, say, if you are a honey bee, only then you can suck in the honey. The flies cannot. So you have to develop that sensitivity. I would say to Indians, I'm sorry to say, that you have to develop that sensitivity within you, which is possible through meditation and through Kundalini awakening and balancing and ultimately getting connected with this all-pervading power of Chaitanya. Because sound is the second state. First was, of course, they said the word, but it was silent, came into sound. And if you can understand the subtle of the sound within you, if you can get one with it, it gives you that joy. Now, you see, because some or other, this is a sahaj trick, I think, that your energy is tuned up to a very subtle and deep understanding of music. Otherwise, it would never have worked like that. I mean, it's the Kundalini, of course, no doubt. But the way she has nourished you to absorb, to understand, to enjoy, this is very subtle music. And it has happened more with the Western people than with the Indians. I'm sorry to say. But Indians don't have that much of understanding nor that much of enjoyment. Westerners may not enjoy, understand, but they enjoy. I'm happy to see this resurrection of Indian music through you people. That was one of my greatest desires, to get the art, handicrafts and music, all kinds of things which are created through this talent should prosper. I have always told you that artists must be respected by all sahajogis, very much respected. The reason is, artists are expressing emotional intelligence. They are expressing emotional intelligence, which is appealing to our heart, to our personality, which soothes down our personality also. It's a special quality of artists that they can produce such entertainment that will awaken your emotional intelligence also, that you will be stirred up emotionally also. It gives you a balance. It's a very great gift of God to the artist that they can create through their emotional intelligence something that entertains you all. You feel entertained, and they themselves, when they produce or create something, they feel very much elated as. They are surprised from where it is coming. It's all coming from within. And that emotional intelligence really makes people get all the qualities of a good human being. Because you can become peaceful, you can become joyous. Also, you can be very generous with this. And always respect artists, and artists must respect artists. I am of this opinion that they should all respect, because they are doing the same thing together, that they are giving this beautiful entertainment to our conscience, which gets this emotional intelligence, which is very important, comes out of the love, the compassion. People in these modern times are so much harassed and so much in a mess. And this kind of entertainment is the best for them, so that they relax into the compassion of the Divine Love. Thank you very much. I thank them very much. And may God bless them. Any other program where there are very few sahayogis, you will see that the way they behave without any respect. The respect that is paid in India to the musicians has to be of a very high level, or any talent, say even art. See also people who make beautiful things from their hands. All these people who are so talented are to be respected very much, because it's a special gift God has given. Now in India we have got a very big problem also. All great artists got into the, into the influence of the West. And so many of them take Scotch whiskey, what do you say to that? So many, and their music is finished. You can't even play cricket with Scotch whiskey, leave alone music. And this Western influence of taking drinks and things like that has ruined our musicians. I don't know what's going to happen. I was quite worried that how is it going to be retained in this country. But now I have great hopes. Because if they see the Western people doing so well, see, for Indians, this goes into their heads. That how can they do it? Oh, that goes very much. If they see Western people doing such good music, it's very influential. So instead of having any Indian artist on the stage, we should really bring foreign. It will have a great effect, I tell you, on India. It was very shameful the way sometimes Indians behave in a classical music programs. Very shameful for anybody.
They have no sense, nothing, and they go on misbehaving. They come there for social affair, I think, that's all. On this point, we Indians as Sahaja Yogis are to be responsible and to see for yourself how much they have achieved. The Indians, when they go for this kind of a very deep type of music, after 15 minutes they start slipping out. Also they told me that in England they went to a music center, or we can say for the buying of the records or something. So all the boys who were there, who were Indians, were buying pop music, that music. And they looked at these Sahaja Yogis, they said, are you stupid fools? Why are you buying this music, this Indian music? What is there in this Indian music? They said, it's better not to talk to you because you are gone. Now, you see, because some or other, this is a Sahaj trick, I think, that your energy is tuned up to a very subtle and deep understanding of music. Otherwise, it would never have worked like that. I mean, it's the Kundalini, of course, no doubt. But the way she has nourished you to absorb, to understand, to enjoy, this is very subtle music. And it has happened more with the Western people than with the Indians. I'm sorry to say. But Indians don't have that much of understanding nor that much of enjoyment. Westerners may not enjoy, may not understand, but they enjoy. Indians feel, those who are, little bit educated in music will start finding out faults, finding out ragas, this was not good, that, no, but not Western. Western people are so humble about it. Isn't it remarkable? How is it they have picked up so quickly and have understood? Because they have become subtler. This is the only thing I can say, they have become subtler and their energies are flowing through the subtler level.
Now the third one I enjoyed very much was the dance. I always admired Kuchipudi the best because it has bhava, where they express all their feelings very clearly, very sweetly, everybody can understand. And also they have a footwork and all that. You have seen how she worked on that thali and how she danced. So these are all the techniques of Indian dancing, which is different from Western dancing. But as many Indians have learned Western dancing, you can also learn Indian dancing, it's not difficult. And there are some Russian girls who are learning Indian dancing in Russia. I was surprised that through the embassy they are learning there. But it's very easy to understand Kuchipudi. That's the easiest thing to understand because very expressive. So I'm very happy to see her dance like this, and she's a Sahaja Yogini. Her husband is a Sahaja Yogi who is a filmmaker. Can you imagine? Such a simple man like him. So it was a very high standard program, I must say, because I never expected one after another such nice programs coming up. And after her dance, we had you people here. I've heard you separately, not together, so many. When there are people I know, they are from different countries, I know them. I've heard them separately, as I say. But I've never heard them together, and your music has to be done collectively. Sometimes you hear individual playing, but it has to be collective with the composer's things before you, and it is to be done in a very meticulous manner, extremely meticulous. I was surprised some Indians got up and went out, but if you go to any hall in the West for a concert or anything like that, opera or anything, you are not even supposed to cough, you know, so much respect is to be given. But for Indian music, you can walk about, talk to people, nobody minds that. Because perhaps people are very liberal, but I think one must respect the artist and the art, otherwise art won't grow. So, now we have here some very nice musicians. I was surprised that none of them made any mistakes, that's the best part of it, though they were coming from different countries. And they did it so well and with such speed and understanding. I wanted them to play this Vinati Suniya, because in India we don't have any notation. Can you imagine? We don't have any composers. Only thing is we have to go through rigorous training for at least, I don't know, I used to think that it's at least 20 years or 30 years, but nowadays I find the Western people get it in 3 years. Something special about them. And after that only they can start singing with their own originality, with their own expressions. They don't need, they themselves are composers, as if they know the whole knowledge, how to build up, how are the melodies are, ragas are, how far to go, how to express, and they are left to themselves to do it. Now there's a rapport between the audience and between them. So that rapport works and they know how to play. This is another style. I would say both styles are all right. There's nothing wrong in any style or another style. But for Indian style, you have to go into a rigorous training. And if there are people who are connoisseurs sitting here, then you can be found out that you are making mistake, you are doing this. But normally, it is very enjoyable. In the same way as your music is. You had composers and composers, and they are different types of people. We couldn't play all of them today. But perhaps I like all of them very much, and I enjoy Western music equally same as Indian music, as well as South Indian music. Music is music. I mean, I don't understand that this music is superior, that music is superior. There's nothing like that. They are all different types of music, and only thing is, you must have a sensitive ear to enjoy it. One's enjoyment is abstract. It is not according to the country, according to any style or anything. Everywhere music has developed, and we should learn to appreciate, to enjoy every type of music.
The greatest problem of human beings is ego. If there is ego, you can't do anything about it. Because he thinks I've done something great, that I have this ego. And they cannot appreciate other people, leave alone loving anybody else. Ego means you love yourself, think no end of yourself. So, India is full of it. Abroad also I've seen it's quite a lot. But at least they know there is ego and they can face it. But this country, I don't know what sort of things they do that they develop this ego. And they think they are quite right. Every country has its own problems. But we have something very great with us, is our music. Not musicians, but music. So the musicians should take to Sahaja. They should meditate. And if a musician is money-oriented, then you cannot help him. Either he should be music-oriented and not money-oriented.
when they are money oriented, they never value themselves, I think. Because if you have music, the talent of music, why should you care for money? And whatever money you give them, they'll be never satisfied. I have seen very great musicians who were never money oriented, who didn't care for power. But we have, even now, many musicians whom I would not say are the last word on music. Those who are very humble. They'll always tell you, we have to still learn a lot. We have to understand a lot.
And if you have to reach them, you have to sing that song, but with depth and with feelings. You have to sing a song with very great depth and feeling. Everything should come from your heart, you see. Then it goes into that being, otherwise it does not. It must come from your heart. So when you sing, you must practice it in such a way that you sing it from your heart. That's very important. It should not be superficially sung, slightly sung, but from your heart it should come. Then practice it. Practicing is very important. You see, in Indian language, we call it riyaz.
Same about Swadhisthana. Swadhisthana is for creativity. Anything you can create. You can create a sari, you can create a beautiful design, pattern, you can create a beautiful art or anything. But as soon as you put it on a mental level, it's finished. Also in the West, too much discussion is about the art. This is not art, that is not art, this should have been like this, that should have been like this. I mean, its creativity is spontaneous. Whatever the artist wants to produce, let him produce. Who are you to judge and criticize? You cannot appreciate anything unless it is brought to the mental level.
But the one thing is there now, see, it has to be rhythmic. Otherwise, if it is not proper rhyme and also in a proper rhythm, as you say, talas. Any music, say it's English, it's Western, whatever it is, it has to have that link. In the Western music, whatever was composed, they used to use beats, I think, in the olden times. But in the modern times, there are no beats, there's no maryadas, nothing. So, in our Sahaja Yoga songs, we all must have maryadas. You cannot just sing something without any beat. You must definitely have beats. If it is a four-beat song, or it's a, I don't know how many beats you have, but we have at least 28 also. I mean, ours is overcomplicated. But doesn't matter, you need not do that. 28 is too much. But up to 60 is simple. So, it must be in beats, first of all. And the tune should be such that it should form a melody. That's important. Because any tune, anywhere, going anywhere, moving anywhere. You see, this kind of composition takes your mind from this to that, to that, to that. But if it's a melody, so you come back again on the sound, on the same point, again on the same theme, you see. And when you come back on the same theme, it's something like your attention is on your spell, same time. So the music now, whatever you compose, should have a rhythmic movement. We should not go out of rhythm, you see, should not. So you should be able to
make it into beads. But I like this new thing that you have. And that one is, what you call that? That you use?
Guitar.
Yeah, guitar. Guitar is one thing I see that it gives you that beat. And in the all modern music, I'm very happy to know, very particular on the beat side. That's very important because beat keeps you the balance, it gives you the discipline of the music, it makes everybody sing all right, and it keeps you in proportion to the whole music. Otherwise, one goes like a long tail of kangaroo, another one goes like a small little tail of a rat, then another one. You see, it is not easy to follow such a music. People get confused. So, because our music is for the masses, our music is not for only few connoisseurs, you see, it is for the masses. So it has to be in rhythmic built, in such a way that the talas or whatever you call the beats have to be properly done, and that's why the modern music is so much appreciated. I tell you, there's nothing in this so-called modern music but is the rhythm with which they capture the heart. And the rhythm is anahata. It goes with anahata, is the heartbeat, is the beating of the vani, is the beating of the force which makes the sound. And that's why beats are very important, and as you know, that it is described in the Devi Mahatmya about me, that very particular about taal, baddha, tied in the taal. Because we have to deal with spirit, which is in taal always. So you should not go out of tune, you should not go out of taal also. So whenever you compose any music, make it a taal, some sort of a beat, keep to that. It's better to have guitar, it's a good idea. But that keeps you in the same rhythm. And you will see that that will be much more appreciated in the masses than a sort of a... we don't have few people, now we have many. So to appeal to the masses, we have to have music that will have a rhythmic building up, talabadha. And you will see, people will appreciate it very much. I'm very happy it's working out so well. And last time in the Easter, people from in Birmingham, late that time, and it turned out to be very nice, you must have heard about it, turned out to be very nice. So let us start with that kind of a thing. Build your music on the guitar style. Have beats there. You will see that it will make a kind of a movement of the kundalini in a proper way. Because poor kundalini does not know what to do now. It moves like that, then it suddenly comes up and goes. So these are different times, and according to the times, we have to compose our music. All right? None of the English people are here with any music as such. Also. What has happened? The one you sang there?
It's got the guitar.
Huh? You must keep the guitar on, always.
Yes, I have it here.
Yes, you should. And you can't use it for Indian music? You can.
Yes, I can.
Very easily. It's just the same. It's very good. It keeps the rhythm on. Guitar must be there. Like this tabla. But tabla is more complicated, as you see, that it has got so many. But Indian music cannot be without rhythm. First, of course, they'll have the vistara, the expansion. But then it must be built. Anybody who doesn't play with tala is not regarded as a musician. You must have that. Because it has something to do with Shiva, it has something to do with your heart, it has something to do with Sahaja. We have to walk in rhythm, huh?
And to do the accompaniment, the Sangat, is a very difficult thing. I think it's easy to play solo, but to go with the mood and everything of the musician, and to bring out the beauty without going into competition, but to slow down at a point and heighten at a point, and all that little things comes from a very large heart and from a heart which is already a realized soul. Otherwise it cannot work out. I have seen people fighting on the stage also sometimes. As you know, her mother is a great musician herself, right? And I hope I'm going to meet her. I went to Benares because she asked me to go there. And it's as if through these musicians also, our family of Sahaj Yoga is expanding so much. And the way they are realizing the oneness of our lives and oneness of our value system. As if they are all getting absolutely lost into our own families of Sahaj Yogis. It's, I don't find any difference because they all have vibrations, they all play with vibrations, and nothing goes wrong. I've seen it just like, as we say, sanchar hona. I felt there was sanchar in them the way they started playing, the whole shakti started moving in them. And it was a remarkable thing I've seen, whether they are Muslims, Christians, Hindus, Sikhs, or anything. It is, this music transcends them. This Nusrat Ali Khan Sahab was sitting on the stage. And he just looked at me. I don't know what he knows about me. He said to me, Ma, come and sit next to me. I was amazed how he recognized me. I was like any other audience sitting there. So I was sitting on the ground. He just called me. I was so surprised at this gentleman, Nusrat Ali Khan. So it transcends, you know. This music is divine, it transcends all races, all religion, all nonsensical, divisive ideas. No doubt about it. And that is what is Sahaj Yoga. And so all these great talents are born today. There were two boys little sitting here, I must tell you. One of them plays very beautiful murli, Eko murli dar, and another plays tabla. Both of them very good and very difficult song they played. I was surprised how they have picked up, and they are picking up so fast. So the talent among Sahaj Yogis, as I told you, that this music of Sata Janam was not only was written down by them in Hindi, absolutely, they didn't know Hindi, in Hindi. Also it was composed. It was put to tune and also to rhythm by them only. Now so, how our music is spreading into their hearts, and this our music, which is Indian music, is really is a divine music. Also they have very beautiful classical music, no doubt about them, and I also enjoy that very much. But our music is a different type, because in this the rapport is established between the artist and the listeners. And every time they can start creating, they have freedom to create. And that's what I think the Sahaj Yogis are just all the time like to hear only our Indian classical music, all the time. And they appreciate it very much. Whatever country they may come from, but you'll be amazed how they enjoy this music. And this is to also say one of the desires of my father, that he said that our music is so divine, it should reach the whole world. I have to specially thank him for one thing, that he has now prepared really for the Guru Purnima for you. He's worked it out really very well. I can see that. I can feel it. It has worked within ourselves, that depth and that beauty. And with music, see, it's this excavation within ourself, you see, facing it within yourself. All these things with music become not only harmless, but also so gentle that you don't feel that it is happening. It just works. You see, the like very gentle waves, it works within you, and you start developing that personality, which is very important for a function like Guru Purnima. And the beauty and the joy, they all work it out so beautifully that you don't feel it, that it's all working, but I know it's feeling. But supposing if I say something as a guru, maybe may hurt you, you may feel upset, and you also may feel facing yourself a little bit, sometimes reluctant, maybe diffident. You might feel a little sort of dejected or depressed, or you may feel sometimes also, if I elevate you, then you might feel egoistical, you see. So the words could not render the services properly as the notes can, because the notes just penetrate within you and work it out so smoothly that you don't feel it's working there. It's working, no doubt. It's like mantras, it works, like mantras only. And when it's enlightened notes, it has great effect. I haven't brought your photographs, where when you are playing before me, you go into complete lights. I have got those photographs. Of course, also we have got Ramadikhaung Vidurva. And we have got photographs now, tomorrow we'll be able to show you, where the lights change their forms, how through vibrations, how they change their forms. And how the vibrations work it out, you see. But even the notes are used by vibrations as vahanas. The notes are used, and the notes take the vahanas position, and they penetrate. When there is somebody you are singing before, a realized soul or a evolved personality, then the chaitanya flows within you. But notes are very helpful. I've seen the beautiful notes. And in harmony, you see, so much in harmony with you that you don't feel the penetration, you don't feel the injection, you don't feel the goading within you. Just it works and it just moves. And I was seeing your brain also opening out quite a lot, because the heart is so much connected with your brain now, you are integrated. So it's wonderful, and you are all becoming thoughtless and beautiful. I think you all have enjoyed his things, and we have to thank him very much, because on a Guru Purnima day that he agreed to come and has done the job halfway for me. I'm thankful to him that now even if I say something, you won't feel hurt. It is nice to be a mother. Mother is a very easy thing, is to just to express your love and the children are nice. But for a mother to be a guru is the most difficult task. And that if I have to do a mother to be a guru, then I think this preparation is a very good idea, because first of all, now you are smoothed out and you are much better. To understand it, I think you require little knowledge about the percussions. If you have that knowledge, then you will understand how it is difficult, how it is intricate, and how it is creative to produce this. It's a very, very long study, long work they have to do, and practices after practices. That's how the Indian art is. But I was surprised that when Sahajogis go in for that, they are remarkable. And we are surprised that in such a short time they can master the art. So there's something special about Sahajogis. And also I was surprised yesterday that from Ukraine those people have come. Otherwise also so many of artists have come from all over, and they were so spontaneous. And I was told that none of them have had any training under any Indian guru or in any Indian school. Just on their own, with the, I don't know how spontaneously Kundalini has worked it out, which part of which chakra it has touched, that these people have developed such beautiful sense of Indian music. I think it's the most difficult thing is Indian music. But it is because it is not like Western music where you have already a composer who has put the composition and you have to read it and that's how you have to play. Composer is also a free man. He can do whatever he likes with his composition. Sometimes it starts slowly, sometimes it starts with a bang, sometimes, I mean, I don't understand the logic behind it. But whatever it is, it's very interesting, and I love your Western music also, if it is classical. Also, jazz is all right. But otherwise, I don't know how to understand pop music very much. Maybe I'm so ignorant about it. Then comes the understanding of our style in Kathak style. And also Kathak, I have seen people learning in the academy have done so well, it's surprisingly, in such a short time, how have they achieved it? Is it Kundalini that works it out? I don't know.
This stability has to come. First of all, our securities are to be built, that we are human beings who have wisdom.
Această stabilitate însă trebuie să vină, trebuie să înțelegeți că sunteți ființe umane dotate cu înțelepciune.
But how do we get this wisdom?
Dar cum obținem această înțelepciune?
What is the way to get this wisdom within us?
Care e calea de a obține înțelepciunea în ființele noastre?
So when this Kundalini rises, she nourishes all these centers.
Când Kundalini se ridică, ea hrănește toți acești centri subtili.
That's how she solves our physical, mental, emotional and spiritual problems.
În acest mod, ea rezolvă toate problemele noastre fizice, emoționale, mentale și spirituale.
See, these are all Romanian singers and singing Sanskrit songs and Hindi Marathi songs so well that nobody can believe they are Romanians.
Vedeți, aceștia sunt niște cântăreți români care cântă cu atâta perfecțiune cântece indiene, sanscrite, în Marathi, încât nimeni nu poate să creadă că e adevărat.
With the awakening of the Kundalini, now they have developed a special type of creativity and sensitivity.
Prin ridicarea energiei Kundalini, ei au în ei o energie care le permite dezvoltarea creativității și a sensibilității.
And also the wisdom.
Și de asemenea înțelepciune.
That we have to be stable people.
Înțelepciunea că trebuie să fim pe calea de mijloc, stabilizați.
When this Kundalini enters into our brain.
Când Kundalini intră în creier,
it enlightens it.
Ea îl iluminează.
Brain is a reality.
Creierul este o realitate.
And then we start seeing the different parts of our brain enlightened and we understand what is reality.
Și începem să observăm cum diferitele părți ale creierului se iluminează și începem să vedem ce este realitatea.
Also, when this Kundalini pierces through your fontanel bone area, you get the actualization of your baptism.
De asemenea, când Kundalini străpunge zona fontanelei, atunci are loc adevăratul botez.
When you get that actualization, când you start feeling on your fingertips the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost, which is what I say, the divine love.
Când acest lucru se întâmplă, începeți să simțiți în vârfurile degetelor și în palme briza răcoroasă divină care este Duhul Sfânt.
You get absolutely relaxed and peaceful.
Thank you. Thank you. Nice music. Asta seara am avut o muzică atât de frumoasă.
From our Romanian Sahajayogis.
Cântată de Sahajayogini români.
There's some sort of a musical atmosphere in Romania, I think.
Există o atmosferă atât de muzicală în România.
Because when you all sing also, you sing it in a very melodious tune.
Deoarece atunci când cântați într-un acord foarte melodios.
Like celestial music that was sung long time back, I feel has come back to Romania.
Simt că când auzind această muzică, simt că mă voi reîntoarce în România.
Was appealing to God was sung by Gandharvas, and I find those Gandharvas are in Romania only.
Muzica care îi place lui Dumnezeu este cântată numai de Gandharva, și Shrimataji găsește că acești Gandharvas sunt numai în România.
Navi Chakra is Black Sea, and that in Greece Athena lived, then all this area must have been the area that is described as heaven in India.
Marea Neagră este Navi Chakra, și dacă Athena, zeița Athena, a locuit în Grecia, înseamnă că toată această zonă este cea descrisă în India drept cerul.
And must have been the olden days when people of Romania or of Greece must be singing praise of God.
Cu siguranță că în vremurile din vechime, oamenii din Grecia și din România cântau laudă lui Dumnezeu.
It seems that these great Gandharvas are born again in your country.
Se pare că acești mari Gandharvas s-au născut din nou în țara voastră.
who came from India were surprised at the aesthetic and the supreme mastery over all kinds of difficult songs by the musicians.
Chiar și oamenii veniți din India sunt uimiți de stăpânirea pe care acești cântăreți o au asupra diferitelor feluri de cântece.
Of course, everywhere people sing now Indian songs with great ease, but the melody that you people produce is not yet achieved by everyone.
Desigur că peste tot acum se cântă cântece indiene cu ușurință, dar melodiile dificile pe care voi le produceți, voi le redați, nu pot fi încă cântate în altă parte.
In Turkey we had invited some people from Hyderabad who were singing Qawwali.
În Turcia noi am invitat cântăreți de Qawwali din Hyderabad.
But when they heard these young boys singing so well, they ran out.
Dar când au auzit acești tineri cântând atât de bine, au fugit.
I asked, where have they gone? I can't see them. They said, they have run away, mommy, Mataji. Because it was too much for them to bear that these boys from Romania, who don't know our language, have mastered this Qawwali so well.
Și Mataji a întrebat, unde ați plecat? Nu, am plecat, nu mai suportăm, am fugit, căci acești tineri din România care nu cunosc limba noastră stăpânesc atât de bine Qawwali.
I have, of course, invited them now to India and they are going to go to the Music Academy.
Și Mataji i-a invitat acum în India și ei vor merge la Academia de Muzică din India.
Also they are coming to attend the wedding of my granddaughter.
De asemenea, ei sunt invitați să participe la nunta nepoatei lui Mataji.
You are also...
Cu toții suntem invitați de asemenea pentru căsătorie.
I used to think India is the only country where the classical music of such a level could be sung.
Credeam până acum că India este singura țară în care o muzică de atât de înalt nivel poate fi cântată.
Because it requires innocence and also attention, which is concentrated.
Pentru că această muzică cere inocență și de asemenea o atenție concentrată.
One has to study this music from very childhood.
Această muzică trebuie studiată de la din copilărie încă.
But how these young people have picked it up so fast, I don't know. We may say it is due to Sergio.
Dar cum acești tineri au reușit să o prindă din zbor, nu știu. Trebuie probabil să o punem pe seama Sahaja Yoga.
Still, I don't know whether it is Sahaja Yoga or these prodigies who have taken birth on this land of Romani.
Nu știu dacă este Sahaja Yoga sau sunt acești oameni miraculoși care s-au născut în România.
Ramana, what in Sanskrit means those who enjoy the spiritual life.
În limba sanscrită, Ramana înseamnă cei care se bucură de viața spirituală.
If Romania has come out of that word, I can see clearly how you are enjoying spiritual life.
Dacă România vine de la acel cuvânt, într-adevăr, și Mataji poate să privindu-ne, să vadă cum ne bucurăm de viața spirituală.
Moreover, you don't understand word by word of this music, but the way you are enjoying is very surprising.
Cu toate că nu înțelegeți cuvânt cu cuvânt aceste cântece, felul în care vă bucurați este surprinzător.
We have a very well-known musician in India, Amjad Ali, who deliberately came to listen to their qawwali.
Un cântăreț faimos din India a venit special să-i asculte cântând qawwali.
And he was so enamored. He said, "What have you done to them? Have you completely transformed them?"
A fost atât de încântat și a întrebat, dar ce le-ați făcut? I-ați transformat cu totul.
I told them they are transformed, all of them are transformed by their own kundalini. Have they not?
Și Mataji a răspuns că
जय श्री माता जी। हम लोगों ने जब श्री माता जी की स्पीचेस के एक्सट्रैक्ट्स निकालना चालू किया तो कम से कम 60-70 पेज भर गए। इतने ज्यादा कंटेंट है श्री माता जी के म्यूजिक के बारे में, आर्टिस्ट के बारे में। तो यहाँ पर जितना हम दिखा सकते थे उतना ही दिखा पाए। हम लोगों ने जो फॉर्म दिया था भरने के लिए सभी सहज आर्टिस्ट और म्यूजिशियंस के लिए, तो हमें बहुत जोरदार रिप्रेजेंटेशन मिला है। वी हैव रिसीव्ड अ ह्यूज रेस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम द सहज आर्टिस्ट एंड म्यूजिशियंस फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर। वी हैव रिसीव्ड रेस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम इटली, मस्कट, स्पेन, टर्की, फ्रांस, कजाकिस्तान, बल्गेरिया, तलियाटी, रशिया, हाउस्टन, पिट्सबर्ग एंड मेनी अदर कंट्रीज। एंड फ्रॉम महाराष्ट्र ऑल्सो वी हैव रिसीव्ड रेस्पॉन्स फ्रॉम वेरियस प्लेसेस लाइक अहमदनगर, पुणे, नवी मुंबई, नागपुर, जलगांव, नासिक, यवतमाल एंड रेस्ट ऑफ इंडिया फ्रॉम वेरियस प्लेसेस लाइक हैदराबाद, केरला, न्यू दिल्ली, मेरठ एटसेट्रा। सो दिस इज अ ह्यूज रेस्पॉन्स दैट वी हैव रिसीव्ड। Few things about the Sahaj artists and musicians, most of them Shri Mataji has covered, but there are 7 or 8 points which I would also like to make. Sahaj Yoga is a very great blessings for Sahaj musicians, and in that Shri Mataji has talked in various speeches about Romanian Sahaj Yogis in how in 3-4 months they have mastered the art of Indian music, which is very tough. They have composed in languages that they did not know, and just in a short span of time. And this is all possible because of surrender to our Guru Shri Mataji, and she is Sakshat Saraswati herself. And there is a speech in which Shri Mataji says that, you know, she did not learn music as she could not get a guru. How can she get a guru for herself when she is Sakshat Saraswati? श्री माता जी की स्पीच में है कि उन्होंने म्यूजिक नहीं सीखा क्योंकि उन्हें गुरु नहीं मिला, एक स्पीच में कहा उन्होंने। और कैसे मिले साक्षात सरस्वती को, गुरु भी कैसे मिले। तो कुछ चीजें आर्टिस्ट के बारे में श्री माता जी ने और कई जगह फोकस किया है जो हम कंटेंट में नहीं डाल सके, कि रियाज और हार्डवर्क बहुत जरूरी है। और उन्होंने, श्री माता जी ने आर्टिस्ट को जिस हिसाब से प्रेज किया, कई सारे आर्टिस्ट को जैसे भीमसेन जोशी, अजीत कड़कड़े, अमजद अली खान, उनको तो श्री माता जी ने बोला कि ये सहयोगी हैं। और कई आर्टिस्ट के बारे में बताया, जैसे केसर भाई केरकर और बहुत सारे आर्टिस्ट के बारे में।
और सबने श्री माता जी के सामने परफॉर्म भी किया है और आज वो किस स्थिति पे पहुंच गए हैं। तो हम सब सहज म्यूजिशियंस का भी ये एम्बिशन होना चाहिए कि हम लोग भी वैसी लिस्ट में हमारा नाम दाखिल करवाएं। श्री माता जी ने एक इंसिडेंट शायद गणपतिपुले में ही कहा था, सारे आर्टिस्ट अपने पैरों पे शॉल रख लेते थे तो अपने गुरु के प्रति आदर भाव से, ताकि यू नो उनके जो आर्टिस्ट के पैर हैं वो अपने गुरु को ना दिखे। तो आप लोगों ने देखा होगा कि बहुत सारे आर्टिस्ट अपने पैरों पे शॉल रख लेते थे, तो कितनी सूक्ष्म बात है ये। और जैसे श्री माता जी हर आर्टिस्ट को जैसे अप्रिशिएट करती थी ना, उनको इलेवेट करती थी, एक अलग स्थिति में ले जाती थी। एक ऐसा भी इंसिडेंट है जो किसी ने बताया है, गणपति पुले का ही है, कि एक आर्टिस्ट अप टू मार्क नहीं था एंड ही वॉज सिंगिंग कंटिन्यूसली, तो श्री माता जी को नींद आ गई एंड जब जगी वो तो उन्होंने कहा कि अरे ये अभी तक गा रहा है। बट आर्टिस्ट को उन्होंने ये पता नहीं चलने दिया कि दैट सी इज नॉट इंटरेस्टेड, और वो आर्टिस्ट को काफी प्रेस की एंड कैसे इलेवेट की। वैसे ही हमें फेलो आर्टिस्ट को, सहज आर्टिस्ट को प्रोत्साहन देके, जैसे श्री माता जी ने हम सभी को प्रोत्साहन दिया है, वैसे ही हमें उनको भी एनकरेज करना चाहिए। और सारे बड़े आर्टिस्ट को हम देखते हैं तो एक ह्यूमिलिटी वाली चीज बहुत मिलती है, और बहुत सारे सहज आर्टिस्ट में कभी कभी हमें लगता है कि यू नो जैसे जैसे नेम फेम हुआ है वैसे वैसे थोड़ा थोड़ा ह्यूमिलिटी की भी कमी मिलती है कई बार, और हमें कई बार लगता है कि मैनेजिंग द सेंसिटिविटी ऑफ आर्टिस्ट इज समटाइम्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट। सो दिस ईगो नीड टू बी रिप्लेस बाय ह्यूमिलिटी। एंड श्री माता जी ने जो बोला है, म्यूजिक ओरिएंटेड वी हैव टू बी, नॉट मनी ओरिएंटेड। एंड पास्ट में वी हैव एक्सपीरियंस दैट कुछ आर्टिस्ट ने सहज परफॉर्मेंसेस को भी मना किया है पैसे के लिए। सो ये भी एक इंट्रोस्पेक्शन वाली बात है। और विजिबिलिटी के लिए या क्रेडिट के लिए अगर आर्टिस्ट लोग ना जाएं तो बहुत अच्छा है। और गाना जो भी इस कलेक्टिविटी में जो गा है वो जितना हृदय से, जितना आप कनेक्शन फील करके गाएंगे और परफॉर्मेंस के तौर पे नहीं गाएंगे, और आपका कनेक्शन महसूस करते हुए और श्री माता जी पे चित रखते हुए गाएंगे, तभी ऑडियंस के साथ कनेक्शन होगा और सबकी कुंडलिनियाँ खुश होगी, और उनकी उनको जो आनंद की अनुभूति होगी वो अलग किस्म की होगी। एक स्पीच में श्री माता जी ने भी कहा है कि अगुरु और कुगुरुओं के सामने उन्होंने एक गुरु का नाम भी लिया है और कहा है कि जो आर्टिस्ट उनके सामने परफॉर्म करने गए थे, हाउ बैडली दे हैव गॉन डाउन। श्री माता जी हैज क्लियरली सेड दैट इफ यू परफॉर्म बिफोर अगुरुज एंड कुगुरुज यू कैन रियली गो डाउन, एंड शी हैज मेंशन वन स्पेसिफिक इंसिडेंट ऑल्सो ऑफ अ कुगुरु। और लास्टली ये कहना है कि हम लोग सहयोगी पहले हैं, हम लोग अपना आनंद और आध्यात्मिक उत्थान की खोज कर रहे हैं और न कि कोई नाम और फेम की खोज कर रहे हैं। तो हमें बहुत इंट्रोस्पेक्टिव रहना है, हमारा अटेंशन हमारे ऊपर हर समय बना रहे, और सहज म्यूजिक लोग जब ही एंजॉय करेंगे जब हम लोग बैलेंस में रहेंगे और कनेक्टेड फील करेंगे। So we have to remember that we are Sahajyogis first. We are seeking joy and spiritual ascent, not name and fame. And we should be very introspective have attention on ourselves. And people will enjoy our music only when we are in balance and when we feel connected. We had asked 3 questions and also asked for suggestions. I will just take few minutes. Because our session is already 90 minutes. So some suggestions that have come, they show lot of depth actually in understanding of music and how it can benefit. So a lot of people who have filled the forms have mentioned, like, the question was, you know, how can music help to grow spiritually, both horizontally and vertically? So what people have mentioned, I'll just very briefly say about what benefits people have mentioned, like inner peace, thoughtless awareness, increases concentration, best way to connect with people. Calmness in mind, relaxation from stress, stability in spiritual ascent, going into depth, inner bliss and peace. Music improves vibration, cleanses our chakras, helps to create balance during meditation, brings out our devotion, intensify our attention. Music opens the heart, unites the collective, generates bhakti, feeling of joy, managing stress, helps in children becoming a holistic personality, feeling relaxed, patience, helps to connect a wider audience as it touches the heart of many, irrespective of religion, age, social status, or language and region. Music attracts and connects people. Sure short way to connect with the divine. Easiest tool for spiritual ascent. It can heal our chakras and help Kundalini rise. Through music, divine vibrations can spread anywhere. Joy, love, and oneness with divine. Music is global language. Realization through music is an excellent tool. Music is language of the soul. So these are some of the expressions that people have used in answering this question. And this clearly says everything about music, and especially Sahaj music. So a lot of suggestions we have received regarding the artists and musicians to improve the reach, to inspire and teach new students. We are definitely looking into that. And our next question after that was, so basically, just to summarize, people want more and more platforms to perform, and also platforms to learn, and also platforms to teach. How digitally we can enable that. And some suggestions that have come to us include, one is shuffling musicians to different places or pujas. Suggestion jo aaya hai wo ye bhi hai ki hame musicians ko bhi safal karna chahiye alag alag puja mein alag alag jagah pe. Music teams smaller at smaller collectives. Smaller teams, music teams हमें smaller collectives में भी बनाने चाहिए. Frequent sessions and workshops, music classes, list of artists should be prepared. There are suggestions for classical dance also. And also some suggestions are there on how we can improve student and teachers' coordination. So it is not possible to go through everything, but we have received very, very valuable suggestions and feedback. And this is very insightful. And बहुत ही अच्छे suggestions आए हैं और इनमें हम जरूर इनको देखेंगे. तो हम लोग अब हमारे पास बहुत सारे, हमने जो लास्ट क्वेश्चन किया था कि आप लोग में से कौन स्टूडेंट है, कौन पढ़ा सकता है, कौन प्रोफेशनल टीचर है, तो करीब करीब हमारे पास जितने रेस्पॉन्सेज आए हैं तो उसमें से 55% आर स्टूडेंट्स, 31% आर टीचर्स, सॉरी 45% आर टीचर्स. सो वी हैव गॉट अ list of all the teachers who can teach. Some of them have also said that we are students and teachers both, but lot of them have said we are professional teachers. To hamare paas kareeb 55% students ke responses hain aur 45% hamare teachers ke responses hain. Aur ye teachers ne ye bhi express kiya hai ki hum log sikhana chahte hain, तो हम लोग उनसे जरूर संपर्क में आएंगे. तो कुछ तो हम लोग कुछ रेगुलरली वर्कशॉप करने की चेष्टा करेंगे जिसमें म्यूजिक परफॉर्मेंसेस भी हो, और नए स्टूडेंट्स के लिए भी अगर कुछ ऑनलाइन कोर्सेस या ऐसी क्लासेस की व्यवस्था कर सकते हैं तो वो जरूर देखेंगे, और आप लोगों के फीडबैक और सजेशंस को भी हम ध्यान से देखेंगे. जय श्री माता जी. आशा है आप लोगों को आज का जो कंपाइलेशन है, कंटेंट है, वो पसंद आया होगा, और एक सेशन में ये सब पूरा कवर करना संभव नहीं था. वी होप यू हैव लाइक्ड आवर कंपाइलेशन एंड द स्पीचेस दैट वी हैव प्लेड. It is not possible to play it in one program. We will try to do more programs going forward, and we'll try to bring together all Sahaj musicians and students together on some platform. Jai Shri Mataji. Before we disconnect, we will be in meditation for some more minutes. Thodi der dhyan mein rahenge. जय श्री माता जी.